All right. So this evening I'll be talking about my probably 4+ year passion project, although I haven't really worked on it too much. It's pretty simple. Karaoke.rb, apparently. The main goals behind when I sought to design something was I liked being able to uncue songs from your phone. So I felt like kind of a headless karaoke jockey, KJ experience was pretty cool for in the realm of, you know, circle of friends sitting in the same room. They could, you know, not have to dig out a songbook or do anything like that. They could see exactly, you know, what songs were in the song library, and then they can hit a button and get in line. I've been to Punch Bowl Social sometime before this whole COVID thing hit.
Rest in peace.
Oh, was it gone?
I think it closed down.
Oh, no. That's unfortunate. But their system was kind of a lot like my system, and I was pretty impressed to see it out in the wild. I also have a standalone mode. Pi Karaoke provides like a minimal interface that you can basically search for any song in sort of a blown up headless environment, or not headless, but you know, on the screen that you're displaying TVs and whatnot, you can search for songs and play them right there. So the overall flow, and I made some diagrams. The singer on a phone or a tablet enqueues a song, which gets picked up by a Raspberry Pi device, or in today's case, my little tiny portable laptop. And then that gets piped to a PA system and video screens. When I started this about 4 years ago, I built it on the things that I liked at the time, mainly Sinatra. With Hamill, I was a pretty big fan of Hamill back then, and Will Paginate. I'm sure everybody has used Will Paginate at some point. When I worked for Nvidia, I liked Rescue, and then I was a Sidekick convert, so everything is Sidekick now. And as far as ORMs, I didn't feel like going Active Record, but instead went the SQL route. The Python bits came in about version 2. Well, no. Version 1 fired off PyKaraoke, because that's an easy thing to fire off karaoke engine-wise on a Raspberry Pi. But the database scraper, so I curate my song list in PyKaraoke to some extent, and then use the pickle file inside of PyKaraoke to populate the MySQL database. The overall architecture, 2 screens from a Raspberry Pi, because they support dual screens now, which is pretty sweet. A hard drive, that's a USB 3 Western Digital platter drive, which is, I actually ran out of space on my USB key, so I grabbed a spare Western Digital hard drive, through the library on it, and I don't think I'll fill that up for a while. So the Sidekick worker talks to the MySQL song database, as well as the Heroku web dyno. This was well before I got into the realm of Kubernetes, at least. And Heroku was still easy. I mean, it still is, but easy. You just plunk down whatever you want. I'm pretty sure I've had the same weird DBD MySQL database for going on for 4+ years now. So the first pass, I had an older Raspberry Pi use Ruby in MySQL. Started with SQLite, but I think I couldn't read the database from the Heroku web dyno. So, because obviously they wanted you to buy a database, so I shifted to MySQL and had all the songs on the accessible via USB key. Had some issues with the hardware, mainly power delivery. If I hooked in too many things, the Raspberry Pi would start to glitch. If I happened to come across a power supply that underpowered the Raspberry Pi, that exacerbated the issue. And at the time, the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi and all that stuff weren't integrated into the hardware. So about in June of this year, I bought a Raspberry Pi 4, has all that stuff integrated, expanded the song library. That's not USB-C, it's actually USB-3. Oh, maybe I should proofread my slides and stuff. But it takes the song list from the Pi Karaoke database and can drive two screens, which was a feature that I wanted to chase after, getting towards more of a real karaoke host setup where you have a screen that everybody else can watch and also a screen that the singer could sing to and, you know, not have to have your back to everybody else, so you could face forward. For those not familiar with Raspberry Pi 4, it does have the two micro HDMI ports, which is pretty sweet. USB-C port that basically gets its power from. I mean, now I've got a dozen at least USB-C devices, so, you know, anytime I want to power the Raspberry Pi, you know, it's super easy. The processor is pretty good. I opted to even, in the first rev, I had an extremely boiled down user interface. Like, there was no GNOME, there was no anything GNOME-like. It was just like, I think it was super dumbed down XFCE that didn't even spawn a taskbar or anything with 8KB memory. Nowadays, I just run whatever stock and it works fine. I think I got the 4GB version, this gigabit internet, not that I would really use it that much, but the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are all on board on the chip, so makes connectivity a little bit easier. So the Heroku web dyno drives a web interface to type in your name, and you type in a simple passphrase. And that's just to prevent anybody who randomly scrolls across on the internet from mucking with your singer queue. Very light session management in Sinatra. I think these were holdovers from the last time I had talked about Karaoke.rb in the Slack chat, because I think Michael or Miles submitted a song or two, as well as my old college roommate's wife. So you can search by artist, search by song title, and in the updated karaoke song list, I now have multiple copies of every song with pretty much any variant of karaoke that exists. So SC is Sound Choice, CB is Chartbusters, and so it would be desirable to sort alphabetically so that you could basically choose which one, but I didn't feel like mucking with the Heroku dyno, so I didn't do that. As far as Ruby code goes, SQL migration, pretty standard, pretty simple database construction. Your standard Sinatra routes. I found that overall the code was pretty simple, which is a little surprising. You come back 4 years later and you look at code that you wrote back then, and you're like, oh, yeah, that's not too bad. I definitely kind of understand what's going on there. Feed in, do the SQL query, grab the songs, do any sort of pagination that you need to, and then fire it off to the view. Super simple. The HAML view, equally simple. When it comes time to push the button, the orange button that you saw earlier, it does a sidekick perform a sync call with the user and the song. And then the worker, wherever it is, whether it be the Raspberry Pi or my little computer sitting next to me, connects to the sidekick view and basically just, if it has a song to play, it'll play it, and then it'll block while that song is playing, and then it, once that's done, it'll ask for the next song and play that too. This is how you view the queue on the website, and this is how the sidekick worker goes in and says, here, runs the job that whatever's on the top of the queue, spawns Pi Karaoke with any options, song base path, because the mount point for the song library can be different, and so it's fed in by environment variable, and then so it spawns the process, waits for it, and then it's done, and then at the top of the queue, the form gets called for whatever. Feature enhancements, since I created this a while back, now I'm a big fan of Vue.js, talking about the JavaScript stuff from earlier, I feel like I could still have the Ruby bits, the Sinatra bits, feeding the database, but I could make the UI a whole lot cleaner with dynamic data-driven bindings that Vue.js affords you. Another mode that would be interesting would be to have the party mode, the standalone mode with the mini quote-unquote UI, and also the phone in queuing. Then I figure you could migrate the Heroku web dyno and the database to Kubernetes dockerization process. All right, so the website that I was talking about is karaoke.nhazi.io. You can put your username in there, and the passphrase is TCNV. One of my old Austin buddies eschewed socially the concept of a name, and well, I guess had everybody call him, they call me Bob. So TCNV. You can pull that up on your phone, and then just a second, I'll switch. Yeah. Screen share over to the karaoke device. We'll give it a minute and we'll have a sip of wine.
Gotta choose really carefully now.
Well, I guess we could do like a brief Q&A if anybody's has any questions about it.
I mean, have you used it? Have you? Is this a house party Has this been brought out at a house party or anything along those lines?
Yeah, so I think the TCMV token came about for, I went to a pretty large house party, set this up, and I've got a PA system much like you do, Miles, with wireless mics, and you can wire mics, and there's a mixer on the back of the speaker. You put it on a tripod, and so I had the Raspberry Pi driving that. And I think the trick was, as long as you could get Wi-Fi access, you could connect to the MySQL database and drive your party. You know, create like a little sign that says this is where the song list is, what the password is, and then people figured it out. It wasn't anything terribly complicated.
That's awesome.
And I've used it for other various, you know, my house parties, which aren't terribly extravagant by any stretch. And I was, with the whole COVID thing, attempting to see whether, you know, karaoke over Zoom would even be feasible. And I just hadn't had a chance to get around to it until this afternoon, yeah, for obvious reasons. Like a new karaoke over Zoom, maybe I should try it first and see.
I mean, I wasn't necessarily. Oh, there we go.
You're like, we'll do it live.
Yeah, right. That sounds good.
What were some of the challenges when you're working on it? You know, the biggest things you kind of like ran into, or like sticking points.
When I was doing it, I was a full stack Ruby developer, so like, not so much anymore. Now I do sort of more DevOps and Kubernetes and Docker stuff. But you know, I knew, you know, somebody submitted a song and I paused it. So I knew basically, I was like, let's make this as simple as possible, keep it simple, so that, you know, if I come back years later or I need to make an emergency fix, you know, I say it's gonna work, and if for some reason isn't working, you know, I kept the code pretty simple. You know, When I started out, I mean, it was simpler, you know, then I had to go from SQLite to MySQL, which was a little bit of a transition, but not terribly complex. And I think I had most of the code written to convert song lists. So the karaoke bar that I used to go to in Austin, Texas, had a songbook, and I was like, now, so somehow, based on something that I found online, I converted it to a song database in SQLite, made a little web wrapper around it, and I did that for two local karaoke places in Austin. So, like, I think I had most of the code when I embarked on my own karaoke collection. So it's kind of interesting to see the evolution.
Yeah. I love. Oh, go ahead. Sorry, Ross.
Oh, I was just saying. Yeah, it really is interesting to hear that evolution.
Yeah, I love hearing about people's passion projects that have been, you know, 4 years in the making, and that sort of thing. I think that's fun. So you used to do karaoke like at least once a week, every week, right? More or less.
Yeah, I would say every Wednesday I was probably in the karaoke bar, and this is dates back to probably about 10 years ago. When did I get married? 2009. I guess it's almost 10 years.
How's your current mental state not being able to do karaoke every Wednesday?
I mean, with my rig, it's always one of those things where I'm like, I can do it if I really want to. I went to, so my karaoke bar around here is Tilly's Pub on 86th Street. And they do karaoke Wednesday. It used to be Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and they added Thursday. And it was getting to the point where I would go a couple times a week. I got it back to Wednesday. I need to be functional. But I even when you could go to bars, totally not recommended given closed ventilation, crowded people, risk of COVID. I stopped in once, right before the bar closed. Sweet talk the KJ into letting me sing a song, but everybody was starting to leave at that point, so I think that was like my one thing. I was like, well, I'm gonna do it now, while things are kind of in limbo. There is no karaoke for probably the foreseeable future until things calm down.
I was trying to think of some sort of responsible karaoke situation, but at minimum, I feel like you have to be everybody brings their own mic.
That's true. The KJ, when the show that I went to had these little microphone condoms.
Oh, there you go. All right.
That you that looked like little surgical masks that you slipped over the microphone. Really affected the audio quality, I think. But better to be safe than sorry. I had brought a microphone, but I forgot that real professional people have XLRs.
Yeah. So
I didn't bring my XLR. I brought my dual pole jack microphone. And she was like, I can do it, but it might be awkward while I re-drink my cord to let it work. Right. So now I've got my my XLR somewhere in a plastic case if I ever get to. If I feel like I need to go sing.
Yeah.
I'll sing and use my own microphone and maybe stand away from everybody else, where everybody else is singing. I don't know.
Right.
It's all kind of a explore. Singing is one of the worst things you can do.
Yeah. Get in as many outdoor venue karaoke sessions in as you can now before winter.
I think that's 100% the truth. I've thought about loading my flat screen with the rolly cart, putting in my truck bed and with my PA speaker and just doing outside pickup truck karaoke in a parking lot.
Love it.
Hopefully the weather holds up for a little while. We don't have a college football, at least for this fall, so maybe I'll dig it out when I would be tailgating normally.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Yeah. If I can share.
For the record, I am cued a song. There's 0% chance that I'm singing at my current level of intoxication. I just wanted to use your app.
Well, get a refill.
Do a quick shout out for the i3 Windows Manager in Linux.
Oh, nice.
Probably my favorite thing at the moment. It's auto tiling and there's no concept of dragging windows around or anything like that. Alright, let's see. Unpause. Wait.
Nice.
There's a couple of Zoom settings that I need to
I feel like it's the 80s again.
Oh, wow. All right.
Different for me.
I mean, it's Stevie Ray Vaughan, so it's like guitar solos with bouts of vocals.
Excellent.
Thank you.
As long as I don't pop it, I think it'll work fine.
Dave was all over it.
Oh yeah, here we go.
Tell me to smile. You stick around and make it worth your while. Not almost behind what you can die. Drink up, so versatile. Now profile. Now we'll be right back. You can hear old child. If I hit a relative to the night. From the marathon to the very last.
Can you hear the microphone?
Oh, very, a little bit. I'll turn my volume
up. I hear you. Excellent. I think that's the only catch 22 with all this is, how do you control the source going in and everybody's microphones going out? Sure, we can hear each other talking. Going on, but it's always like a balance sort of thing.
Yeah, and there might be a market for a company buying a license to this for their zoo and just having no doubt. Simply they don't know what's happening. Or the
I know if I was running this over Discord, you could do volumes for everybody individually, which I think is pretty sweet. Am I ready to sing Bill Collins right now? Can you feel it coming in the air tonight? Oh, 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 oh. Well, if you don't, we're telling, I would not lend a hand. I've seen your face before, my friend, but I don't know if you know who I am. Well, I was there. I saw it with my own two eyes.
Yeah, this is awesome stuff. I think adding a good clap.
If you open up the door, we'll all come inside and eat your brain. I'd like to help you, Tom, in any way I can. I sure appreciate the way you're working with me. I'm not a monster, Tom. Well, technically I am.
Like
it's really not that readable.
Oh, I turned off the, is it mode?
Well, not that that's necessarily important, I just...
There you go. Yeah. So if you, you can tell Zoom to optimize for video. And so, it'll probably rejigger the compression to focus on movement rather than like text and stuff.
Huh. That was just really slick. You know, key those songs right up and have them play here on there.
Yeah, they just keep on coming. They're putting these things on like laser discs and CDs, you know, since the late 80s, early 90s. The Pioneer ones are probably the first ones, and then, you know, it's kind of snowballed from there. It used to be MP3, or it used to be WAV files with this CDG format. And obviously nobody wanted to cart around WAV files, so they most karaoke engines support MP3. So they rip the WAV file, convert it to MP3, and then pair it with the CDG file, which has the timing information and the text.
Cool. very interesting. So you might have talked about it, and I just, my short-term memory is failing me. Sorry, my wife is using a wine bottle to turn off the lights right now, so her hands are full. That's what she has to use. Wine hands. Anyway, what do you think your biggest technical challenge was during the course of, I know it's been four plus years possibly at this point, but
I mean it's been a pretty steady evolution. I think because somebody did ask this question before, I'll just recap briefly. A lot of it was code that I had written for other uses, like being able to reliably search karaoke venues that I frequent in Austin. There was two of them. So I think most of the UI part I had written already. It was just, how do you do the asynchronous worker workflow around, you know, getting karaoke to work, you know, in sort of a headless thing. You know, the laptop is sitting here, it's waiting for a job. If it gets a job, it'll start playing the song. I mean, with a full stack engineering background, you know, this is what I was doing 90% of the time.
Yeah.
I was writing it to workflow. So, I mean, it came pretty easily in the end, I think.
Cool.
What's the significance of needing the jobs? Like, why? What part of it needed to be asynchronous to make that work with the, you know, that we had to push off into the job?
I mean, it's just the Redis based queue, I think, was probably the impetus. If I were to do it today, I would just write the person who wants to sing and the song title or the song ID, which is basically what Sidekick is doing, and then just pop things off of the Redis queue in order to do the job. It's basically what any Sidekick or Rescue or whatever is doing, just, you know, has a more significant wrapper and extra features like retries and exponential back bump and all that stuff.
That makes sense. So it's mostly for the actual queuing function of it.
Yeah, it's just it'll block while it's playing a song, and then whenever it's ready to play the next song, when the song ends or somebody presses escape to cancel the current one, the next song is ready to go.
Very cool.
Hey. Cool. Any other questions, thoughts, comments?
You know, I had no idea you could just find the karaoke stuff yourself. I thought it had to come from like a VHS system, a PA system. So it was cool to see some of the, like, the actual things that I've seen in the bars at karaoke. Like, I have a particular vibe coming at me on the screen, like, "We keep America singing." I'm like, oh, I know exactly where I've seen that. That's pretty fun. I might have to find some of that.
I'm sure everybody's been to a bar where they have the classic bar karaoke. And, you know, that was what I like to sing against. So I, you know, my home collection definitely reflected, you know, the same tracks and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. That was pretty cool.